How did AI start understanding language? Between 2013 and 2018, word embeddings transformed words into mathematical vectors, mapping meaning through context. Words with similar meanings or context were placed close together, enabling AI to grasp relationships, synonyms, and even nuances. Let's break it down and see some key methods. The first method, Word2Vec, was developed by Google and introduced in 2013. It converts words into vectors by analyzing their relationships based on surrounding context. This approach demonstrated that numerical representations can capture word meanings effectively. The second method is Global Vectors for Word Representation, was developed by Stanford and introduced in 2014. It enhances Word2Vec by using global co-occurrence statistics, analyzing how often words appear together in a large text corpus. And the third method is FastText, was developed by Facebook AI Research and introduced in 2016. It represents words through sub-word components, improving performance with rare or unknown words. These methods laid the foundation for more advanced natural language processing models, revolutionizing how machines understand and process language. Word2Vec transforms words into vectors into multidimensional space, placing similar words closer together. This conversion is essential since machine learning models require numerical input, not plain text. By analyzing word relationships in context, Word2Vec captures word meanings through their vector representations. Word2Vec is like a map where nearby towns represent words with similar meanings, while distant towns symbolize words with different contexts or meanings. Word2Vec learns word relationships by analyzing the context in which they appear. Cities like Athens will be closer to Greece, Paris will be close to France, Amsterdam will be close to Netherlands. Tokyo will be farther away since it is in a different region of the world. Athens is close to Paris and Amsterdam because they are all European capitals. Amsterdam is closer to Paris than to Athens due to cultural and economic ties. Tokyo is far from all three but could be linked with Japan and Osaka. How does Word2Vec measure word proximity? Word2Vec positions words in a high-dimensional space based on their contextual relationships. There are two main learning models. The first model, Continuous Bag of Words, predicts a missing word based on its surrounding words. If we have the capital of is Paris, the model predicts France. The second learning model is skip-gram model. It predicts surrounding words based on a given word, for example, Athens. The model learns that nearby words include Greece, Acropolis, and Olympics. What does Global Vectors for Word Representation bring to the table? Analyzes the entire corpus to capture both local context and global word co-occurrences. Global Vectors for Word Representation creates a more detailed word map, considering both direct relationships and long-range connections. How is Global Vectors for Word Representation different from Word2Vec? Word2Vec emphasizes local context, similar to street-level navigation, by analyzing nearby words. Word2Vec learns by scanning text windows, like looking at small neighborhoods, and it builds relationships based on proximity in sentences. Global Vectors for Word Representation utilizes global co-occurrences, much like a satellite view of a city, capturing the broader relationships between words. Global Vectors for Word Representation counts how often words appear together in the entire dataset, and it understands broad relationships, not just immediate context. Global Vectors for Word Representation, it recognizes that Athens is more associated with history and philosophy, while Paris is linked to fashion and culture. when to use Word2Vec and global vectors for word representation. Use Word2Vec when focusing on predicting words in a sentence, for example, chatbot training or next word prediction. Use global vectors for word representation when you need a global understanding of word relationships, for example, search engines or recommendation systems. What does FastText bring to the table? FastText takes word embeddings to the next level by looking at subwords, units, which are parts of words. This makes it better at handling rare words, typos, and morphologically rich languages like Romanian or German. In the case of Word2Vec and global vectors for word representation, if a word is misspelled like Amsterdam instead of Amsterdam, it won't be recognized. These models rely on exact word matches, so any variation or typo will result in an unknown word. Amsterdam could be broken into Amsterdam, so if a misspelled version appears, for example Amsterdam, FastText still understand. In short, if Word2Vec and global vectors for word representation create a city map using full street names, FastText adds house numbers and alleyways, making navigation even more precise.